A new report's found that eating a single freshwater fish is the same as drinking dangerous PFAS chemicals. Okay, first of all, most people don't know what PFAS is. Do you agree with that?
Oh, absolutely.
It's been knocking around out there. We tried the first time PFAS ever got into the public domain were the trials that I had up in West Virginia. They made two movies out of it. One was called The Devil We Know. It's on Netflix. The other one was about the lawyer who brought the case to me. Brilliant lawyer. Named Rob Bilott. It's called Dark Waters. Begin by watching those movies to understand how bad this is. Okay. PFAS is so dangerous that if you take one drop, put it in an Olympic-sized pool, it's going to have the propensity to cause the physical problems that we're talking about, which are what?
We're talking about neurological problems, cancers of every imaginable kind for the individuals, birth defects. And the big problem here, too, and you've discussed this plenty of times, is that it's bioaccumulative, mm-hmm. which means once it gets in you, it's in you. So every PFAS chemical you drink after that is just compiling and building up inside your system.
And explain why it's in fish. Explain why it's in our drinking water. Talk about
exactly.
that.
Exactly. It's the waste from these massive corporations that have been dumping it for decades. Yeah. Our EPA right now still doesn't know exactly if we're going to stop this because it's still happening. They're still debating on what the proper limits are, but there's no limit.
50 years. 50 years. The EPA has known that PFAS, the first cases we tried were C8. It was a type of PFAS. So we found the documents. The EPA understood that all of the rat studies were a disaster. All of the beagle studies, they all died. All the monkey studies, they all died. And it was caused by this stuff that is in our drinking water right now. The second phase of this case that we're handling right now is all these drinking water facilities, the delivery facilities. They have so much PFAS in the water, it would take $100 to $200 million per facility to get it out of the water.
And so now what we're looking at, this new study from the Environmental Working Group says one freshwater fish, just one, if you were to eat that right now for lunch, that's the equivalent of drinking nothing but PFAS basically for an entire month, one fish. And these freshwater fish they're talking about, these supply foods to communities. They're a huge source of food for low-income Americans who always bear the brunt of all of these environmental toxins, mm-hmm. Native populations. All of these groups heavily dependent on these fish, and we're finding out now we're poisoning you even faster than the rest of us are being poisoned because everybody's getting it, but they're getting it
worse. You want to know how it happened? You know what came out in the trial? Okay, it's 3M and DuPont were the big, big folks in this. They did all this testing. They saw that all the tests were a disaster, causing kidney cancer, causing testicular cancer, causing neurological problems, causing birth defects, all of this information they had. Now, for a little while, they hid it from the EPA, but then at some point, they handed it over to the EPA. EPA did nothing. There was nothing that was done by the EPA. All right. Working groups, environmental working groups, gave it to the media. Don't you think this was 40 years ago? Don't you think this is an important story, New York Times? Don't you think this is important, Washington Post? No, it wasn't, because obviously advertising money was moving into those entities. Television wouldn't do it. 3M, check your TVs. 3M advertises like crazy, people. So even the so-called investigative corporate types weren't doing anything on this project. Then regulators, we found out that the regulators that were supposed to be in charge of all this were moving from being regulators to going to work for 3M in million-dollar jobs, or DuPont going to work, going from regulation to DuPont. It was this revolving door, and it went the other way. People who worked for the industry were putting people in administrative positions with the EPA to slow it all down. And Farron, I swear to God, if you say, isn't that PFAS a problem to 10 people? If you get one of them to even understand it's in their body, it's in their drinking water, They don't get it.
No, it's what is it? At least 98% of all life on Earth at this point has PFAS chemicals
in it. Polar bears have it. It's so bad that they had to find blood that they could do epidemiology studies with. They couldn't find it with contemporaries. They had to go to the soldiers that were in Korea to look at their blood samples to even be able to compare, because they didn't have it in their blood because it hadn't started then.